It's bad.
Thank you.
Oh my god. That scared the crap out of me, Dalton.
Wait till tournament time, Dalton.
What then?
Mom's gonna be crazy.
No.
He's coming. Poked him in the eye. He's done. Left, right, left, right.
Which one? That one that's walking on me?
He's funny. I love him.
You're gonna have to sit down sometime.
Hey, if you can't have fun, you're not a foul out. What are we doing here?
He's not gonna sit down, so they can't see it.
That guy's got some personality.
We made a point.
Just let him.
Hoiberg.
And Wolfolk, 9 points, 9 rebounds tonight. Heads to the foul line for a fair. If there's been a bright spot for
La, 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 la.
Production off the bench. You mentioned Wolfolk and Griffiths have been outstanding. Wolfolk, especially in the first half, I think, came in there and gave them a nice lift because they weren't able to get anything going because of how Nebraska was defending Emory. Wolfer came in and made his presence known on both ends. And on to the board, one more to go. He's tied his single game high in rebounds with 9. Trying to match his single game high in points, can get a free throw to fall as Alec sits down, maybe for the final time, gets a great round of applause on senior night here in Lincoln.
Oh, get it!
Called.
Then we foul again immediately.
Austin Williams. No, it'll be on Juwan Gary. They called Gary for the foul for a hold, and that'll send Austin Williams to the free throw line for two free throws.
We're trying to help him out.
To that offensive repertoire no matter what. And they just have continued the battle. They weren't able to
win. They had this in single digits here well into the second half.
And it was the Casey Tominaga run, this, a 7-0 spurt that really keyed the Huskers pulling away maybe for good, because it's not as if Nebraska has torn the cover off the basketball the last 5 minutes. No field goals in the last 5 minutes and 6 seconds. They missed their last eight shots, but it was Tominaga that keyed the Huskers.
Yeah. He moves so well without the ball. They spread the floor for him, showing his versatility and a chance for an and one. And then this is kind of in the midst of, you mentioned that 7-0 run. It came in, I believe it was 48 seconds of clock time.
Of his 18 in the second half, and on senior night, dad looking on, Huskers trying to close out a senior night win, 50.9 seconds to play in the second half.
Kevin, you mentioned the year that Nebraska has had thus far, and a lot of basketball still to be played for the Cornhuskers moving forward, but you look back in the rearview mirror, this is the team that finished 12th in the conference a year ago, and picked the finish right around that, if not right at 12, coming into this season, and to be able to take the disparate people that they've been able to take off the transfer portal and plug them in with some guys that were returning has been really impressive, and that's why I think that that guy right now, Fred Hoiberg, he's not the leader in the clubhouse for Coach of the Year in this league. He is certainly getting more than honorable mention for that award.
Timeout used by Nebraska, and I agree with you. You look at the work that Nebraska has done in really changing their program over the last couple of years. You saw it at the end of last year. Nebraska, from February 1st last year, went 6-2. They were better on defense, and you could see the turn happening. But then people found voids like those left by Derek Walker. They found Greg Bass to fill that void, and they put in some pieces. Other guys expanded their game.
Even Hoiberg has one of those bra things on, too.
I don't know what those are.
Since last February 1st, and Mike DeCourcy
has a project
that is 10 seed right now in his latest bracket. No bad losses for the Huskers. And this is the last quad three situation that Nebraska has on the schedule in the regular season.
This is a quad three?
Michigan next weekend.
Why was last game we played quad one? Why are we getting hit the road yet?
Huskers will be very
now they're not going to foul.
Are they content to let the game go out? It looks like they maybe are.
Yeah, I guess
it's over. It's over.
It's over.
11 points. It's over.
Why would he dribble out?
I don't know. That was silly. Really? That was the most craziest last 45 seconds I've ever seen in my life.
Even gonna try.
Well, yes.
Well, you would think so. I mean, we're fourth in the Big Ten. They're going to take more than four Big Ten teams, aren't they?